Hello friends, respected seniors and colleagues in nursing profession. Welcome to NNF Kerala Action Plan Newborn 2020 Online Learning Module 1 for nurses practicing in care of newborn. At the onset, I would like to express my gratitude to the organizers of Kerala NNF and Ernakulam branch for their help and support for this module. During this pandemic season, as it is not possible to conduct classes directly, learning consisting of 7 modules with 1 module every month in 2 video presentation is being planned by webinar series. As already said, we will be focusing less theory and will be more on practicals. In this attempt to bring out to you twice a month, we are uploading this presentation into the YouTube channel of NNF Kerala. Please subscribe to get notification and share these videos with all your friends. With this introduction, let us go into the topic proper. So myself, Dr. A.B. Matthew from Kochi, we will discuss the second part of the thermal care of newborn. For the kind attention of our first time viewers, the first part can be viewed in the YouTube channel of typing NNF Kerala. So there we have discussed the following points, like if we are not maintaining adequate warmth of a baby, that is between 36.5 to 37.5, the baby can result in hypothermia, resulting in sickness and in newborn death. Second point discussed was, we have seen how loss of temperature occurs by the 4 mechanisms, and as nursing professionals, how we can modify our care practices. The third point which was discussed was, we have seen a pictorial representation of 10 vital things starting from the point of delivery till the baby reaches home. And these 10 vital things are joined to form the warm chain. So any break in this chain at any point of time will be dangerous for the baby. And lastly, we have seen the practical things of how to clothe the baby to maintain adequate warmth. So in the second part today, we will learn 1, how to manage hypothermia, 2, how to manage hyperthermia, 3, practical aspects of thermometer, 4, practical aspects of radiant warmer, and lastly, kangaroo mother care. We can keep the temperature normal by recording the 2 T's, the mnemonic. First T is for temperature and the second T is for touch. So when we record the temperature in axilla, it should be between 36.5 to 37.5. Coming to the next T, the touch, which is done by the tactile method, which we have discussed in the last presentation. We use the dorsum of our hand to touch the abdomen and then the feet. Suppose if the feet and abdomen are warm, then the baby is perfect. That is, baby is in thermo comfort. So how do we measure? Some questions asked are whether it is the clinical thermometer or the digital thermometer or the new generation non-contact infrared forehead thermometer. Let us see some questions. Which site is the best? Axilla or oral or rectal? Should I add 1 degree to the reading? Or how long should I keep? So let's see the ideal ways to measure. If you are using a clinical thermometer, you have to hold for 3 minutes in the axilla. Or if you are using a digital thermometer, you will hold till a beep is heard. Suppose if your technique is correct and you are measuring the core temperature, there is no need to add 0.5 or 1 degree to the reading. Suppose if you are keeping the thermometer in contact with skin, you have to clean the thermometer first with spirit swab. Suppose if you are using a clinical thermometer, before taking the reading, you should shake so that the mercury comes down. So the ideal ways to measure. One most important thing is that when the baby is lying on the warmer, it may be sweating. So the axilla may be moist. Ensure that the axilla is dry and you will keep the thermometer in such a way that the bulb should not protrude out. It should remain in the apex of the axilla and the stem parallel to the chest wall. As seen in this picture, you should hold the baby's arm firmly against the chest wall. So if you are measuring like this, the axilla gives the core temperature and so there is no need of adding 0.5 or 1 degree to it. So let us see some case scenarios which we see in our day-to-day postings. The first scenario is you are on duty in a postnatal ward. At 5 p.m. you get a call from a bedside of a mother who delivered in morning by normal vaginal delivery to a term 3.5 kg male baby. Their complaint is baby is not sucking at breast, baby is fully sleepy and not arousable. You rush to the bedside. Window near the bedside is open, diaper cloth is wet, temperature is 36 degree in axilla, baby is bluish and on touching with dorsum of the hand, abdomen is warm and feet is cold. So what will you advise? So I guess from the previous presentation that you would have come to the conclusion. So let's see. Your observations may be the window is open. So as we have learned, there is heat loss by convection. Cold flowing air is there. So you should close the windows. The clothing is wet and inadequate. So there is loss of heat by conduction as well as evaporation, and you have to use a warm diaper. Any newborn baby, we should see the breastfeeding aspect also, like the correct signs of attachment as well as teaching of how to hold the baby in the correct technique. So like the mnemonic we learned now, the first T shows from this scenario that it is 36 degree. And the second T for touch shows that the abdomen is warm and feet cold. So we come to the confirmation that the baby is in cold stress or mild hypothermia. In our busy duty schedule, don't forget three things: educate, communicate, and document. So communicate with the duty doctor, educate, that is teach bystander how to keep the baby warm, and document, that is you have to document the temperature and monitor temperature again regularly. So this slide takes us back to our previous memories. What all things which we should do in this case scenario to prevent heat loss in the postnatal ward. One is you have to remove all wet cloth and cover with adequate warm cloth. Second is the environment should be kept warm, that is the bed as well as the room. And you should promote skin-to-skin contact with the mother. You will have to promote breastfeeding, as well as you will have to monitor the temperature as well. So just a brush up of what we have learned from the last video. What is abnormal? So hypothermia can be divided into three. One is the mild hypothermia or the cold stress, which we have just seen in this case scenario. That is, the temperature is 36 to 36.5. Moderate hypothermia is when the temperature is between 32 to 36 degree. And severe hypothermia, when the temperature goes below 32 degree and we need active intervention and the baby has to be admitted to the ICU and put on the warmer. So let us now discuss the symptoms of hypothermia. The baby can have poor cry and activity. Baby can have breathing difficulty and the need of oxygen. Can have infection resulting in need of antibiotics. Can have poor feeding resulting in need of IV fluid. And if this continues, baby can go into a serious stage of convulsion and coma. All this could be prevented if we can provide adequate warmth and prevent the baby from going into hypothermia. So we will see the next case scenario. This is a common scenario which all of us will have to undergo in one day or other in our nursing profession. You got a new job as a NICU nurse, staff nurse in a hospital. On your first day of duty, you would be briefed by the nurse in charge regarding the nursing protocol of the unit. How would you be briefed regarding the thermoregulation of admitted babies in the unit? So I think my question is clear. In simple language, how do you handle the newborn warmth in the ICU? So in this era of quality initiative and implementation, the three pillars on which nursing profession or any medical department stands are: one, hygiene; two, documentation; and three, communication. So in the ward and the ICU, there should be strict asepsis with hand washing, and the thermometer and the skin probe should be cleaned with spirit swab before using. And secondly, documentation should be done in all the monitoring charts. And lastly, it is not communication alone, but effective communication should be there between the nurses, doctors, as well as the parents. As times have changed, so has also nursing practices. When you see the picture on the right side, the clinical thermometer is kept in a bottle immersed in alcohol solution. To my viewers, is this practice nowadays? No. Why? Because there is chance of risk of infection. So the ideal way now followed is shown in the picture on the left side. That is, each bed of the baby should have a separate thermometer, which should be kept in a sterile container. And before using the thermometer, should be cleaned with spirit swab. Coming to monitoring chart, machines are not always perfect, so you should depend on your brains. I am sure all hospitals will have a monitoring chart with roughly almost all these clinical parameters. So today we will discuss the first three columns. And as the webinar progresses, we will be completing all the parameters later on. So in the first column, the duty sister has entered the time 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. She has come for morning duty, so her entry time was 8 a.m. and the exit time was 3 p.m. So if you could appreciate, when coming to the right top corner of this chart, it is written hourly, second hourly, fourth hourly, and sixth hourly. And the sister has rounded the hourly. So as you can see, the temperature monitoring has been done hourly. And you see a green letter at the entry time as well as the exit time, which the sister has done manually by checking the auxiliary temperature. Rest of the thermometer readings were taken directly from the warmer reading. The third column is the heater output. Different company warmers have different ways of showing the heater output. So we will discuss it in the another module. Coming to the third case scenario, a 35 week 2.4 kg late preterm was born to a third gravida mother. On day 3 of life at night, duty sisters get called from the room where the baby was shifted from the ICU the previous day. The complaint was that the baby has not passed urine since afternoon and is not sucking at breast since evening. So the sister rushes to room. Baby's abdomen and feet are cold to touch. Baby is less active, poor cry, jittery, shallow breathing, mottled skin. So she takes the phone and calls the duty resident doctor, who advises to check the temperature and sugar by glucometer. We know that skin-to-skin contact is the best way to provide warmth, but like in this case scenario which we have just discussed about this day 3 old preterm, 35 week 2.4 kg, when temperature maintenance failed and baby had symptoms like poor activity and breathing difficulty. So as advised by the doctor, she has checked the temperature, which is 31 degree, it is less than 32, and the sugar is low, that is 24 milligram per deciliter. So coming to our mnemonic 2T, since it is less than 32 degree and both the abdomen and the feet are cold, the baby comes in severe hypothermia. So it is an emergency and the duty resident advised the baby to shift to the NICU to be kept on the warmer. So how will you manage this severe hypothermia? So we came to the NICU, we have put the baby on warmer. The manual mode is kept with 100% heater output. We do rapid warming in manual, and once baby temperature reaches 34 degrees centigrade, we switch to the servo mode and then do a slow rewarming. And thereafter, we do a regular temperature monitoring. Other measures which are needed are, since the sugar was low, we have to put IV fluid. And since baby had breathing difficulty, it needs oxygen. And we will be discussing warmer in the following slides. So our viewers in the ICU will be familiar, but for the general viewers, I will just discuss the part of the radiant warmer. So the A is the cot seater, which provides the radiant heat. The B is the control panel, which displays the temperature and has the control switches on it. And C is the skin probe, which is attached to the baby and which records the infant temperature. And D is the bassinet, which is used for placing the baby. So we will see each one by one, the control panel. The three main components of the panel are: one is the display, as you see here. The display below is what we set on the warmer, whereas the display above is the temperature given by the skin probe on from the baby's temperature. So the next are the switches on both sides. The left is for the modes, that is the servo and the manual, and the switches on the right are for increasing or decreasing the temperature. And as you see, the third thing is the heater output. Here it is seen that the warmer is giving 50% of heater output. So we will discuss the manual mode here, and you can see that the warmer has to be switched on first and the manual mode should be pressed. There is no need to set the temperature here. The probe also need not be placed, and this we use for pre-warming the warmer as well as the cloth 20 to 30 minutes before delivery. And also we did this manual mode for the baby in the case scenario which we have discussed just now for rapidly rewarming. But one risk which is involved here is it can result in overheating of the baby. So you have to hourly measure the axillary temperature. So before discussing the servo mode, we will just see the working principle of the electric iron box, which works on the principle of thermostat. So if we want to iron our cloth, we will have a switch one with a lower temperature for wool, and a switch maybe a three for higher temperature for cotton cloth. So if we are ironing a wool cloth, once the temperature of one switch one is reached, it automatically gets cut off. Similarly, when we are keeping the switch three and ironing the cotton cloth, once the temperature set for the cotton cloth is reached, it automatically gets switched off. The same principle is working on this warmer. Let's see this control panel. You see the temperature of the warmer is set at 36.5, and the skin probe takes the baby's temperature and it shows the temperature as 36.5, which is equal to the warmer. And in this servo mode, the warmer gets cut off. So the heater output becomes zero here. So this is a computer operated, and it adjusts the heater output of coil to keep the neonate at 36.5. And it is decided automatically by the baby's skin temperature. And this is the preferred method. So what is abnormal? When body temperature becomes high, that is more than 37.5 degrees centigrade, it is hyperthermia. So we will see this case scenario 4. The baby, term baby, is on the warmer, and the alarms are beeping due to a high temperature. So let me take that my attention to the viewers. Do you find anything abnormal with this baby? Yes, the skin probe has fallen off from the skin and it is just hanging. So on observing, the baby is hot to touch and the skin probe is loose. So here the hyperthermia, the cause was equipment related, that is probe displacement. So coming to high alarms, the alarm beeps when the temperature of the baby comes at least more than 0.5 degree of the set temperature. Let's see this. We have the 36.5 set as the temperature of the warmer, but the infant reading is 39.2. So what would you do in such scenarios? You should at first verify the axillary temperature manually by using a thermometer. Second thing which you will do is, like the case which we have just seen now, we will check the probe attachment. And also we will find out the reasons. Like the reason for a high temperature may be phototherapy or an overwrapping baby, or it may be due to infection. So let us observe this baby in this picture. Baby is lying on its back and the skin probe is attached on the right side of the abdomen, just over the liver. So in the supine position, the probe is attached in the right hypochondrium. Suppose the baby is lying on the chest, the probe will be attached somewhere in the sides, that is the flank. And you should make sure that the shiny surface of the skin, shiny surface will be towards the skin and the insulated surface will be towards the outside. And the probe should be free of contact with the bed. Here we have used a Tegaderm to fix. You can use Micropore as well as you can use costly Duoderm if it is an extremely preterm baby to prevent skin injury. So we will see this scenario 5. So this is a term baby on phototherapy. The warmer alarm is beeping because of this high temperature. And the sister switches off the warmer and calls the doctor. By the way, the sister did a mistake here. Did anybody of you notice? Yes. She has switched off the warmer. So this is a case of hyperthermia due to phototherapy. And in such a case, never switch off the phototherapy. Never switch off the warmer unit, but you will have to switch the phototherapy early. So this is another case scenario 6. You see a day 2 old term baby of an elderly primate during night rounds feels too warm and irritable with incessant crying. On examination, baby is hot, 38 degree, not passed urine since more than 12 hours. So it is a case of hyperthermia due to dehydration, that is due to less milk. So another important nursing aspect which we commonly ignore is the feeding issues. We have to make sure the mother has good signs of attachment as well as the method of holding and technique of the baby is correct. So this comes to the causes of hyperthermia, that is more than 37.5. We will think of common causes first, like a high room temperature, 2, many layers of cloth, 3, dehydration, just we saw in the previous slide, or it may be iatrogenic, that is the mother taking any medicines, or 5, the equipment or warmer errors, which we have just seen in the case of a probe detachment. And the 6th may be sepsis. One personal request to the viewers here is, don't ignore alarms and don't mute it as we are used to it at every time. So the alarm can beep even if the temperature is also low. We can just see this diagram here in this. The set temperature of the warmer was 36.5, but the patient temperature is only 25.3 as indicated by the green light showing a low temperature. So the warmer is working full at 100% output. So what can be the causes of this? It can be due to cold draft of air, or the warmer got complained, or it can be due to the sister handling the baby recently and the baby getting wet due to urine, or it can be due to the baby not having the cap, socks or the cling wrap. So a discussion of thermal care would not be complete without a discussion of kangaroo mother care. For our viewers who want to know more about theory, there is a beautiful module available on the website given in the right hand side, the newbornwhocc.org. Since our module is focusing only on the practical aspects, there is another beautiful video describing the A to Z of the practical aspects in YouTube, which was done under the leadership of Dr. Ashok Derari in collaboration with WHO and AIIMS New Delhi. And I recommend this video to all of the viewers here. Generally, kangaroo mother care is done in preterm babies less than 2 kg when the baby is stable, when the baby is off ventilator and off IV fluid, the baby has a good muscle tone, the airway is clear. You have to train at least 2 members selected by the mother, and moreover, you have to educate regarding the benefits as well as the procedure. The kangaroo mother care is not usually done by only the female members of the family. It can also be done by the father. And education of the mother is important. Her privacy is must, and her clothing. Moreover, we'll have to train the staff adequately. And the kangaroo positioning, that is positioning the baby between the breast with the baby in upright position with the neck turned to one side and slightly extended. And you have to teach the mother to observe the breathing pattern as well as feeding. And there is no time limit for kangaroo care. You can continue as long as you wish. Make sure that the mother is on a comfortable chair with an adjustable backrest. So let us see the benefits of kangaroo care. Since it improves the breastfeeding, baby can have early discharge. Since the temperature is maintained, there is less chance of hypothermia, there is better growth of the baby, and more importantly, there is better utilization of resources in our limited settings. So let us see some frequently asked questions to the sisters. Is there any need of clothing the baby on warmer? Yes, we need. We have to wear cap and socks. Suppose if the baby is stable, it can be clothed, but make sure the skin probe is in proper position. Suppose the baby is sick and we have to monitor the abdomen and chest, okay, you can at least cover the head and extremities. So another frequently asked question is how to recognize that the baby is sick by just touching. In other words, how to differentiate an overheated baby from a febrile baby. So if the baby is overheated, the baby will be active, the skin will be pink with warm hands and feet. But in case of a sick baby, even if the baby is under warmer, baby's hand and feet will be cold and they will be lethargic and will have pale skin. So before winding up, let's ask some questions to ourselves, how much we have understood about the things we have heard so far. So my first question is, what is the set temperature of a womb? The second question is, in case of severe hypothermia, how is rewarming done? The third question is, the site of attachment of probe in a baby. The fourth question is, in case of hyperthermia, which to switch off, either the warmer or the phototherapy? And the last question is, are clothes allowed on a baby in warmer? Okay, I hope that the viewers are ready with their answers. So we will check at the answers. So the first answer was, they said warmer temperature should be 36.5. The second answer was rapid rewarming is in manual mode till 34 degree and thereafter slow rewarming is done. The third answer was in supine position, we keep the probe in the right hypochondrium, and in the prone position, we will keep in the flank position. And fourth answer was, you should switch off only the phototherapy and not the warmer. And the last answer was, yes, clothes can be worn on a baby in warmer. So before we wind up, let's summarize what we have learned so far. So if we are measuring in proper technique, we will get the core temperature, and so we don't need to add 0.5 or 1 degree. Some of us will be muting the warmer as soon as an alarm occurs, and so henceforth we will make a change in our nursing practice. That is, we will genuinely check for alarm and make a safety check of the equipment wherever it is needed. The third thing is that we will always check the breastfeeding of the baby to avoid hyperthermia. And lastly, we should always promote the practice of kangaroo mother care. So in the next module 2, we will see with neonatal equipment, the basic concepts, as well as the practical issues we commonly face in these equipments. So at the end of this module 1, I hope the take-home message is loud and clear. Our nursing practice should be modified to maintain the optimum temperature, that is between 36.5 and 37.5 degree from delivery room till the baby reaches home. And strictly maintaining this warm chain prevents babies from becoming sick and help in better growth. Thank you all for your patient hearing and hope this presentation was useful. Goodbye.